Yo， 大家好，这里是中国制造肌肉哥。那么欢迎来到我的频道。今天肌肉哥想和视频前的小伙伴们聊一聊关于我们男人之间的这点事情。那尤其是当下正在奋斗的年轻男性同胞啊，我们其实都在努力的生活，希望去构建一个美好的未来，在未来能有一个幸福的生活。而现实是，随着祖国的发展，当下的年轻人确实在物质生活条件方面要比几十年前好上太多了，但问题就出在，明明是当下的物质条件更加的优越，但很多男性同胞却在抱怨眼下的生活压力变得更大，那甚至有人开始去怀念过去的日子。类似这样的话题，其实在网络上有很多不同的看法和声音，说什么的都有。但肌肉哥今天想带大家伙去看一看西方世界，找一找答案。那我们都知道，在很多年前，西方的物质生活条件其实要比几十年前的中国更加优越。那也许我们可以从一个全新的角度，在西方世界中找到这个解决问题的方法。
Many men actually don't benefit from marriages or relationships anymore, and people are always going to have to require some degree of incentive. I think that we've set up the world now in a way where men are seen as worker droids. They're expected to go to work all day, come home, clean up as well, share the cleaning with the woman, not have any meal prepared for them, not have any authority over the household, and just be a worker droid and sad. I don't think that many people understand that men are intrinsically wired to desire respect amongst their peers and in our environments. This is why CEOs work so hard they get respect in their company. This is why we all want so much money, fast cars, status, and influence because we're respected. Men desire respect like we desire oxygen. And if a man's coming home to a household where he doesn't feel any respect, he's not gonna wanna be there for very long.
网络上很多人将当下年轻人的不开心问题归咎于生活压力大、工作压力大、钱不够花等等等等。当然，肌肉哥不能否认物质是生活保障这样的一个客观条件，但问题就出在当下我们明明的物质条件要远远是优于过去的，而对于一个能满足生活必需条件的男性来说，我们真的对物质上的那种渴望有那么强烈吗？那之所以今天想带小伙伴从这个西方视频中去找答案，是因为这条视频用了一个全新的角度，尊重来解释当下西方男性所面临的问题。而眼下忙碌的生活中，男性似乎忽视了尊重对于我们男性的这种重要性。人们都说我们中国人爱面子，但其实仔细想想，这种面子的背后不就是隐藏了咱们中国男性对于这种尊重的渴望吗？
The way you fix this is you need to understand that many men don't have the incentive to be in the house anymore. But it'd be quite easy for a woman to make a man really happy with super basic things. Just go up to your husband and say, Hey, you know more about this. What do you think about this? That would make most men's world. There are so many sexless marriages out there with men working their asses off.And they come home to a terrible marriage and kids don't even like them. If you were to just even ask him this question about some bullshit, he would feel so happy to feel like the man of the house. That's what men need. They need to feel like, all this work I'm putting in, all this mess I'm going through, I'm respected for it. As soon as a man feels like he has no respect, that's the absolute end of a man's interest or a man's tolerance of a situation. I think that's the reason it's happening. I think I know a lot of men who completely love their wives.They love him with all their heart, but he's just not respected in this house. He doesn't get to be the man of the house. You don't have that much influence. Now you're coming home to a household where everyone just thinks you're the dude who should just work. You're just a worker, you're the slave, you're the robot, and your feelings don't matter and your authority doesn't matter. If you watch any Netflix show, the mother is the smart one and the man is the bumbling idiot. Turn on a family show. The mother is the one, hey, calm down, I'm smart. And the man's look, ooh, beer.They're reducing the man to just an idiot. It's very hard, I think, for a lot of men to accept being in a position of constant disrespect. I'll tell you this now, if I had to choose a long-lasting marriage with a woman who loved me, or a woman who truly respected me, I might choose respect over love, even though they're the same thing for a woman, because if she loves you, she respects you by default. But if I had to choose, I've been through too much and worked too hard and gone through too much in day-to-day life to come home to my house and be having battles over bullshit. I take care of you and I love you with all of my heart. I would die for you if someone broke into this house, but please just cook dinner. It's the disrespect that will drive a man to the most heinous of crimes. It's the disrespect that starts the school shooter bullshit. It's the disrespect that makes men go to jail for life sentences. It's disrespectful when you truly disrespect a man in a public and permanent way. That's when they switch.
我想很多小伙伴应该能够理解为什么在西方有很多的男人会去选择去东南亚的一些国家寻找爱情了吧。那西方的一些所谓发达国家，其实在很久之前就已经出现了像我们今天所面对的这种婚姻和出生率下降的问题。那这也是为什么这些西方发达国家一直去试图是引进外来移民，去填补他们本国这种劳动力不足。外加这些年美国在这种能有88种性别的文化影响下，你们猜一猜，那今天生活在美国家庭中的男人会不会被他们的爱人所尊重？外加西方这种非常操蛋的婚姻法，美国这种强调对抗文化的国家，想要去建立人和人之间相互尊重，变得几乎是非常奢侈的事情，更不要说去建立这种家庭的信任感。那这时候如果大家再去想一想，今天我们看见美国街头的那些流浪汉，美国之所以会沦落到今天这个地步，什么无家可归、零元购、毒品泛滥以及各种枪击事件，一方面是经济问题，毕竟嘛，早些年美国可以在全世界去割韭菜，可能那时候的美国男人挣钱要比现在更加轻松。那所以即使当时一部分的美国男人在家庭没办法获得他们爱人的尊重，但是他们还是可以靠用 dollar 去买一点尊重的。当然这里的尊重肌肉哥是要打上引号的，因为我们都知道真正的尊重是用钱换不来的，而今天美国早已不可同日而语，所以随之而来美国这种缺文化的致命缺陷就暴露无遗了。有人说，肌肉哥你说的不对，我在美国玩的时候那里的人都会很友好的和你打招呼。那我想对这部分朋友说一句，请你们分清楚尊重和客气之间的区别，没有尊重的客气真的有意义吗？没有人和人之间的相互理解，你真的在乎别人那句 hello 吗？今天的视频就和大家聊到这里，肌肉哥也希望通过这个视频让大家理解到，我一直觉得我们今天所面临的种种问题都是因为一些西方不良文化而导致的，但是我也一直相信凭借着我们中国文化的这种智慧以及包容，我们一定可以解决掉今天美国等一些西方人解决不掉的问题。我们的文化一直强调包容和理解，所以我们千万不要被一些西方那种争勇斗狠的内容所迷惑，更不要去学西方人那种搞对立和排斥。我们在保护好自己的同时，要尽可能的去理解生活在自己周围的人，给自己以及自己的家人、朋友、社会更多的尊重。好了，今天就和大家聊到这里，希望大家一如既往喜欢我的内容。最后不要忘记一键三连 Peace。